This video will cover how to represent bridge features in an SRH 2D model using SMS. Representing a bridge crossing in a 2D model includes the ground surface under the bridge, the abutments, the piers, and the deck. The 2D model representation of flow through a bridge opening primarily applies to the terrain under the bridge. This surface, which may include the channel and some floodplain area, is represented by the mesh. Remember that LiDAR data does not typically include data points under bridge decks, so additional survey data may be necessary to correctly represent the terrain and the abutments under the bridge deck. Because bridge locations typically cause a constriction in the floodplain hydraulics, relatively small mesh elements are typically warranted at bridge locations due to the rapidly varying hydraulics and interest in more detailed hydraulic results at these locations. Typically, element spacing in the area of a bridge is selected so that several elements are located under the bridge in both directions, laterally as well as upstream to downstream. Abutments are typically sloped or vertical, both of which can be represented by the mesh. Sloped abutments can be represented like other terrain features. Vertical abutments can be represented by creating a hole in the mesh, which acts like a vertical wall, or by creating steep elements that approximate a vertical wall. If the simulated scenario does not include a discharge where water comes into contact with the bottom of the bridge deck and there are no piers, representing the terrain under the bridge deck and the abutments is sufficient to simulate the flow through the bridge. If a bridge location includes piers, there are three methods available to represent bridge piers in SRH. The first method is to create a hole in the mesh to represent the area of the pier. The hole does not have to be the exact size of the pier outline and can be a representative area for complex piers. Representing piers with a hole in the mesh is recommended when more detailed hydraulic results are desired to the bridge opening and the pier size is not significantly smaller than mesh elements in the bridge area. The second method is similar, except instead of making a hole in the mesh, elements representing piers are designated as an unassigned material type, which informs the model not to include that element in calculations. The third method is to use an obstruction to represent piers. Obstructions are useful when the pier size is small compared to the typical elements, or if detailed hydraulics are not necessary at the pier location. When representing piers with obstructions, SRH increases the material roughness value to account for pier drag force within an element. This method can accurately represent upstream backwater effects caused by piers, but does not provide accurate velocities and flow patterns in the vicinity of the pier. The bridge deck should be represented in the model if the water level reaches the elevation of the low chord. Since the mesh is used to represent the terrain, the bridge deck must be represented in the model in another way. In SRH, bridge decks can be represented two different ways. The first method is to represent the bridge deck with boundary condition lines at the upstream and downstream face of the bridge. The mesh must be created so that elements align with the bridge deck structure. The low chord and high chord of the bridge structure can be entered in the bridge deck boundary condition window. The influence of a bridge deck can be split into two components, including pressure flow under the bridge and weir flow over the bridge if necessary. The low chord elevation is entered to inform the model when the deck will start impacting the water surface. The low chord can be a single elevation or a complex shape. If flow is expected to overtop the bridge deck, then SRH can use the bridge crest elevation to calculate weir flow over the deck. The weir flow calculation will remove flow from the upstream face of the bridge and return it at the downstream face of the bridge. The second method for representing bridge decks in SRH is to use an obstruction. This method is similar to how piers can be represented and functions in the same way by increasing the roughness of elements to account for the drag force of a bridge deck. When using an obstruction to represent the bridge deck, Backwater due to the hydraulic impacts of the deck will be accounted for, but the velocities in the vicinity of the bridge deck will be reduced due to the increased roughness. Therefore, using obstructions for bridge decks is typically limited to bridge structures that are not directly related to the purpose of the model. Representing bridge features is an important part of creating 2D models, especially for transportation-related hydraulic analysis. You can download a one-page summary with links to additional resources here.